Learn why KQL is the next query language you should learn and learn how to get started this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined once again by Hamish. Hamish, thanks so much for joining us today. Before we get into the show, can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, sure. And thanks again for having me along, Anna. It's a real privilege. G'day, everyone. I'm Hamish Watson from Christchurch, New Zealand. I'm a data platform MVP, and I run my own company, as well as doing a whole heap of stuff in the community. And really looking forward to just introducing you all to KQL today.
Awesome. Yeah. And that brings us right into the topic, which is KQL, the next query language you need to learn. So I'd love if you could tell us a little bit about what KQL is and why you feel like it's the next language folks should learn.
Yeah, sure. So KQL is short for Kusto Query Language. And basically, it uses the Kusto query, the Kusto engine to query big data sets. And how I came across it was I use Azure as my platform for spinning up resources to, both deal with data as well as spinning up, web servers, Azure functions, what have you. And behind the scenes, all of the diagnostic information is fed into Azure Monitor for all those resources, right? So Azure SQL database, the whole lot of the resources. And so being able to query that diagnostic information was just an eye-opener for me, because not only could I query it using KQL, but I could turn those queries into an alert so that if, say, my Azure SQL database had crossed a threshold in CPU percentage used, or even the number of vCores that it was using, then I could use that query that I'd written and turn that into proactive actions, i.e. being able to either, scale up my database, or letting us know that, something is going above that threshold. And over time, I learned more and more how to use KQL. I've written in T-SQL for a wee while, but I want to just take you to a really cool page that helped me out so much. And that is the SQL to Kusto cheat sheet. And so in here, you will find all sorts of information, ways to write your queries. And it's awesome because it gives the examples on the left of how I would write it if I was writing in SQL, and on the right-hand side, how that maps or translates to writing in KQL. And so over time, my queries started very simple at the beginning, but over time they got more and more complex. Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. This is really helpful. I actually didn't know this page existed, so thank you for sharing with me. I've just kind of been hacking along, but I could see how this would be much more useful. Can you show us an example of kind of like using KQL in action?
Yeah, absolutely. And the really cool thing is that Microsoft have given us a free portal to actually use. So all you need is an account in Azure, which of course can be free. And it's a really simple URL, aka.ms/LA demo. So this is a demo of log analytics up in Azure. And so Microsoft have got a whole heap of data up there that we can query. And so, that query could be as simple as looking at some performance data, and we can use all the operators that we're used to, time generated what we could do, first of all, is just run, do we have any data in the last 24 hours? And this is performance data that we're looking at. And what we can do is just like any query, we may actually look at, you know, where we're searching for memory. And the awesome thing about this is that we have the ability to, you know, build out our queries as complex as we want. And I guess my comment here would be, you know, it's limitless in terms of what you can get out of the diagnostic information. Now, this information relates to VMs, but as I said before, we can query on Azure SQL database. We can do it on our app services, our functions, logic apps, anything. Because, you know, when we set up our resources in Azure, you know, we're going to set up our diagnostic information to go into log analytics. So again, this is a free place where you can come along and actually test out how to write in Kusto Query Language. And, you know, there's, the as I said, the limit is just whatever, you know, you want to write. So that was, and one thing I will call out is, let's say I had a query that I'd written and let's say I had a query where I wanted to create an alert. So again, you basically run your query here and you would hit new alert rule. Now, you can't do that because it's the free one, but in Azure, we can definitely do that. So that leads me on to the next thing that I used KQL with, which was Azure Data Explorer. So you can go and visit Microsoft's website in docs.microsoft and look at Azure Data Explorer. Basically, it is a platform, it's a cluster that allows us to ingest terabytes of data really, really quickly. And we use KQL over that to read that data and get information. One thing I will say is that it is read-only. So we're not actually going to modify data. We're just, again, ingesting it, we're exploring it, and then we may actually pass the results of our query onto, you know, other things. So I'm going to take you into a really cool bit of one of the utilities Microsoft have, and that's dataexplorer.azure.com. This is the online version of being able to, you know, utilize our Azure Data Explorer. In the past, I used Azure Data Studio on my computer, and that doesn't mean that I won't, but it means that I can use this online version anywhere that I want. So here I have my cluster, which I built earlier today. And I created a database in there. So it doesn't have any tables. So we are going to create a table. We've created a table storm events. And what I'm going to do is ingest from blob storage some data that Microsoft have given us as an example. So if you do go to the Azure Data Explorer page on docs.microsoft.com, there is a link that will show you the quick start of how to create a cluster, create your database, which is literally, you know, a click or, you know, create statement, and doing what I'm doing here. And so this will take, well, it's finished. and what we can do is, you know, do a quick count of what we have on our table. So we've got 59,066 rows. And now what I'll do is actually show you some really cool things of what we can do. Just like the log analytics platform, it has autocomplete, which is great for people like myself. And, you know, we can use shift enter to run our command, or we can click run. And so this is showing us the version of, you know, some information around our database. I did the count before, and as you'll see here, I've just got some, you know, random examples of what we can do using KQL. The probably, you know, we all know what where clauses are. So, you know, it's the thing I'm going to say here is that what you see here is very similar to what we would use in other languages in terms of the construct and what have you, in terms of the operators. You just have to, you know, just do it a slightly different way. You know, I'm going to drop my table because I don't need it. My table, gone. you know, and so go and look at the cheat sheet. The cheat sheet is really, really cool. Look at docs.microsoft.com. It's great. And if you're like me, you're going to spend hours just seeing, you know, what information you can get out of that data. And again, Azure Data Explorer is a fantastic platform to do that ingestion of massive amounts of data.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Hamish. This has been a great introduction to KQL. Also, I think it's given myself and maybe our viewers kind of some affirmation that, like, hey, you can learn KQL. Your T-SQL skills translate very well. And we even have a guide that shows you how to do that. And then it was cool to see some of the different interfaces, whether it's Azure Monitor, where you were showing us some of the logs where we can interact for free, or getting into an actual example in Azure Data Explorer. We also know it's possible in Azure Data Studio. So Hamish, thanks so much. This has been really useful. If you had any final tips, what would you tell our viewers?
My tip would to be just go out and try it. You know, there's so many different free ways of trying some of this out. You will find that you will have to be using KQL at some stage, because generally when people need information from data, they come to people that write queries with those people. So, you know, go and learn it. It's a really cool tool to have in terms of helping, you know, businesses manage their platforms way, way better.
Awesome. Well, thanks again, Hamish, so much for being on the show. To our viewers, thanks so much for joining us. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.